Okay, so now we're going to take care of the sides. And all we're, the sides and the back. And all we're going to do is put some gel in it, brush it, and flick it down. So I'm using jam. I like this because it doesn't make my hair hard. It actually makes my hair soft as I put it in. I'm going to take some of that, rub it in my hands. I'm in desperate need of a haircut right now. But we might do with what we have right now. And you just want to get those side parts flat as you can, and the back also. I'm taking this teeny tiny brush and just kind of going in like that. Now, after I do that, I go in with my my Velcro wrap, and I'm going to show you guys that. Okay, so this is a Velcro wrap. And usually what I do, after I brush down the sides, I put this on just to ensure that it stays flat. And you want to put it like that, so that way you're covering the back, and there's no hair sticking out. And you want to be careful of your hair here in front, because you don't want to smash it down, then it gets wet, and you have to flat iron it over again. So usually if I'm going to go out, I'll curl the top, I'll put my Velcro wrap on. And you're definitely going to need bobby pins also. Yeah, I like that. I like a lot of volume up here, so I'm not going to comb that down, just kind of use my fingers to create more volume. And that's pretty much it. Of course, I'm going to go in with my comb and with my fingers and kind of perfected the way that I like it, but it's really simple. So I hope you guys like it. I'm definitely going to do more of these. If you guys have short hairstyles that you have pictures of, you can send me a message. You can send them to my email address, and I'll try to do tutorials on them. So thank you guys for watching. Bye. Now, as far as hair products go, I do not stand by any one product. I kind of experiment and use different things. So, of course, I use a wrap lotion. This is a Smooth and Shine Polishing Silk Style Foaming Wrapping Lotion. And after I wash my hair, I get it all out. I take tons of it and flick my hair down with it. And after that, I use my styling strips, and I just take them and kind of wrap all around my head, and sometimes I let it air dry, sometimes I sit under the dryer. It really just depends. Now, this bedhead manipulator, somebody told me about it, so I bought it. It's $18. I personally do not recommend it. I don't think this was intended for my hair texture. When I put this in my hair, I feel like I'm putting gum in my hair. Can you see that? I'm not saying that it's bad, but I just don't think it's right for my hair texture. But, and, damn, of course, this is great, because, it doesn't leave your hair hard. Or at least it doesn't leave my hair hard. It makes my hair soft. And, what else? Y2 comb is always great, especially with one of these little things. You can use it to part your hair. And definitely one of these little brushes right here. This is the brand is Annie. So I just use this to kind of go in like that. Flatiron, of course. Inch flatiron and a half inch flatiron is great because I have longer hair on the top and shorter hair on the side. So a smaller flatiron is great for the sides and the back if your hair is cut like mine. And I think that's it as far as hair products go. Before I forget, like I always do, I want to tell you guys about the makeup that I have on. The eyeshadow is from the Coastal Scents palette. It's the Shimmer and Matte palette. Just a light green and a dark green. And I don't know if you can see it, but I also have on a purple glitter eyeliner. I don't know if you guys can see that. Lipstick that I have on, it's a Nika K lipstick called Black Orchid. And I also have that on with CoverGirl Wet Flip Wet Shine lipstick. And Raisin Blush, MAC Blush. And these false eyelashes, I just have them on in the corner too. That looks more natural to me. And in the actual tutorial, the only difference is the lipstick. And I have on Girl About Town lipstick with my NYX Jumbo Pencil Milk. And then my MAC Dazzle Glass lip gloss. So that's it.